today being 18th day, 18th day of May 2018, let it be on record that time shall come in this country, Nigeria, sooner than expected, before the government of APC under the President Muhammadu Buhari goes down.
Before they step down
or before they complete their tenure, time shall come in a particular day that there will be a kind of hardship that youths will not be able to bear it again, and the youths will come up in mass to protest. There will be a kind of protest and different kind of pressure measures will be used to stop them, but they will grow like a wildfire. I see the youth spreading, moving everywhere. I see the government trying to stop them. I see them fighting for their rights. Pray that many bloods will not be shedded in that time. But all I want you to know that it shall come to pass. But after that, I see a new Nigeria. I see a new Nigeria. I see a new Nigeria. For Nigeria shall be great again. Sorry, many have been saying Biafra agitation, Biafra agitation. We are an open field, and thank God for the land of Plateau. And thank God also for the land of Shendan local government, where we are having the program in open field. But I want us to know that I see Biafra is going. Let it be all right. I see them going. But their going is no more going to be with war, bullets, and all these things. I see them going. I see other foreign countries also trying to put mouth. I see Nigeria government then trying to have a kind of dialogue. But let it be on record that in this 2018, 2019, 2020, by the grace of God Almighty, after the youth protest, time shall come when the leaders, the big men in this country, begin to run to hide. I want us to know that Nigeria is going to experience hardship. But after that, there will be revolution. Tell your neighbor, there will be what? A revolution. And when this message was given to me, God also gave me a song. And I sang it before.
And that song says
what? I see a new Nigeria. Those of you that were there when I caught the revelation and I sang it, sing along with me. I see a new Nigeria, I see a new Nigeria in the hand of God. I see a new Nigeria, I see a new Nigeria in the hands of God. I see a new Nigeria as a nation shall be great again. And I want us also to pray against bloodshed in this country. Pray, because there are a particular tribe that will come up, that because they are in the leadership, they will try to subdue others. They will try to subdue others. They will try everything possible to ensure that other tribes are being marginalized. But in whichever way, we should know that Nigeria is one. There be division, but not now. I pray that when the youth will start protesting, and when the government will try to quench this fire, and that time it will be difficult for them, international bodies will try to intervene. And when international bodies go into it,
it may affect the Nigerian
leadership. Pray also that the pressure, that the bloodshed will not come upon the youths.
Because
if the youths are being massacred, the military may take over again. The democracy you are enjoying now, the democracy that the leaders deny us, then Nigeria may experience a kind of autocracy from the military. But the military will be there for a revival,
for a
government of the Nigeria governance, for the new Nigeria. I'm sorry, I'm not a politician. I preach the Bible, and I tell you what God told me. And that is why I said that that date should be marked and should be on record. That this day, 18th May 2018, should be recorded and be visited anywhere. That if it doesn't come to pass, where youths will rise up to fight for their right under the leadership of the President Muhammadu Buhari, something will come up a day. There will be kind of protests. The protest that we make the thing that, we can stop. No. Look, the protests will go wide like a wildfire. It will not only be protested in Nigeria, there's some other places across the globe. I know who sent me. It's unfortunate that other big prophets might have not spoken about this.
But I want you to know
that God chooses what to tell his people. When you know that the prophet has spoken is when it comes to pass. If God sends me, it shall come to pass. Before President Muhammadu Buhari steps down, before he finishes his tenure, if God permits him to finish it alive, somebody shall fire. If God permits him to finish it alive, if he remains on the seat alive, there'll be a massive protest here and there. Look, placing people on curfew, going on curfew will not be the solution. But my advice to the Mr. President when that time comes is this: let him call upon the people. Instead of, look, let him forget about the people who write speech for him in the paper. Let him come. He's a father. Let him come and address Nigeria and say, my children, we are his children, including me. Your Excellency, Mr. President, when that time comes, we are your children, including me. He should just, my children, please come, let us dialogue. What is it that you people need? He will come to the need of his people, settle the youth. Any government that will not go with the youth will not last. Forget about some youths that will give them 100,000, 50,000, they'll go into burning and other things. That shall come when the youth will rebel against the leaders. Let it be on record. And let the video go viral, I don't care. But when you know that a prophet has spoken, is when it comes to pass. All I know is I see a new Nigeria. Nigeria shall be great again. Yeah. I see protests, people fighting for their rights, the uniform versus the civilian. But the truth, justice will prevail. I also see a country coming out of Nigeria. Not just only a country. When a country makes a move to come out, other countries will try also to spring out. Nigeria shall be great. Hey, I wish that this country will be a United States of Nigeria. The Biafra, they are going. Other ones are going. My earnest prayer is that if Nigeria is to be divided, let the middle belt also go. Do you know the middle belt has the food that the whole Nigerians eat?
Yes, sir.
Do you know?
Yes, sir.
Do you know that no middle belt, no Nigeria? Do you know what I mean by saying that? The middle belt can feed this nation for 4 years without even depending on government, because their land is fertile and their youths are strong. Are you people not strong?
Yes.
Are you not great farmers?
Yes.
Do you know how many trucks that load yam from the Shendan local government to other parts of the country? Do you know how many trucks that move yam, that move grains from this Shendan local government to even Niger Republic? And you think you're not strong? Middle belt, God bless you with agriculture. Sir, if God bless them with what? With fuel, petrol, or let's say, what is it called? Crude oil, right?
Mineral resources.
The Northerner, God bless them. God bless everybody. A state like Maiduguri, like Yobe State, God bless them and equally give them that in the place they can get fish that others will, you know, celebrate. We are not here to discuss politics, but we are here to tell us that prophecy fulfilled is prophecy revealed by God. Celebrate God. Let's go into the word of God.
What?
Thank you for the call.